What's up, guys? It's Track, and this is pretty new, isn't it? So you saw it here first on the Nerf News, and I appreciate you guys commenting and liking and letting me know what you thought of it. But this is the real deal. This is a production sample of the Elite 2.0 Commander Nerf Blaster. Now, it is exactly what we thought it was, guys. It's a six-shot revolver designed to kind of iterate on the strong arm platform of sorts. Now, some of you guys pointed out that it's not as much like a strong arm as it is like a disruptor. And the truth of the matter is that to me, this is still a Maverick by another name. Like, once you've been doing this for a decade, I still think of terms like in-strike levels. So the Commander is a simple front-loading six-shot revolver. We're going to go ahead and throw a few darts in here. Admittedly, this does make it a little trickier to get in here. There's really only one port on either side that's a smooth entrance, so you're loading one at a time instead of two at a time. That was something that was nice about the Maverick, is that since it had a drop, particularly with a drop cylinder mod, it was much, much easier to just kind of grab a handful of darts and shove them in the barrels quickly. Now, I do want to point out that ergonomically, the grip area is a little bit wee, but not that bad. Then you've got this little choil here. If your hands are large, you chew up the choil. But if your hands are smaller, and if I can simulate that, right? Anyway, bottom line, this claw is designed to hook into this so that if you wanted to dual wield these, you could theoretically do that with the claw. That said, I don't think that that makes a whole lot of sense. So this is auto-retracting, which is nice. And then the trigger is a kind of single action that fires and rotates afterwards. So first it fires and then it rotates. It's got good barrel alignment. It seems to be hitting solid elite style performance. We'll take it outside and put it over the chronograph in a minute, but I do want to talk briefly about the styling. Looks pretty okay from one side. This has grown on me. The recess here in the plastic into this orange actually looks quite good. The paint is actually very clean when they deigned to give it to us. And then on the other side, you lose a lot of this kind of Tron aesthetic, which is more evident on the box, but does bleed into the design of the blaster itself to all these warning logos. Then the lack of the paint just completely drowns out the overall aesthetic. The marbling kind of coloration here is growing on me. I can't help but think that the combination of teal and orange is like trying way, way too hard to be like a FedEx logo. That said, to answer your question, yes, it does have slam fire. I think that slam fire is more at home on a revolver than it is on a rifle, for sure. In certain circumstances, I like that you can kind of cowboy it, if that makes sense, whereas frequently slam fire is such a loss of accuracy depending upon how you do it that it's not worth it. Now, the one thing that is ridiculous is, guys, this is a revolver. I like the in-strike attachment on the front. I don't explicitly like the stock attachment, but I have questions. Why is there a rail on the handguard? Why is there a top rail up here? And then why is there a bottom rail here? So theoretically, this is supposed to be a tactical six-shot revolver. Check it out. All right, so this is the level of ridiculous that Hasbro thinks that we're about with this revolver. First off, if you have any sight up here other than like maybe a pinpoint sight, you can no longer grip this thing comfortably. You have to kind of sneak in like that to get it ready to go. The stock is a little tight for a revolver. And again, like, am I tactically wielding? Like, what clownery is this? I feel like to pull this off, I need a red rubber nose and a t-shirt that says Dude Bro on it. The muzzle's just gonna cost you a lot of velocity, although I think that the silencer could look handsome. And then, is this for stability? Is this so that we can really be a true man of accuracy here with our precision sniper revolver? And then you've got a foregrip, obviously, right? So I don't look goofy at all. This is too much, guys. And it also kind of brings to light that, like, the fact that Hasbro thinks that every new refresh, every new reskin, every new cash grab needs its own unique styling that does not play well with others is pretty obnoxious. Because you wind up with just the most helter-skelter looking blasters. It would be far, far cooler to get new blaster designs in color schemes that at least complemented the one that came before it. At least the one that came before it. Like, I'll grant you that it's hard to match neon yellow from InStrike, but the fact that we've got, like, our modulus stuff doesn't even look good here is pretty rough. It's very jarring, I feel. But we're going to strip this guy down, take it outside, put a few over the chronograph, let you know what it looks like in terms of its overall FPS. We'll find out just exactly how much of this we have to be doing on today's video. One thing that I want to mention about the Commander from Elite 2.0, they've really cheaped out on these rail attachment bits. They've taken them from being a piece in a spring, which was quite nice, to a piece with kind of a plastic sort of torsion spring, a simple machine, and that was okay. So now there's just no spring. They're just cutting a hole into this and hoping that that's good enough. These are nowhere near as nice. While I did do the goofy gimmick to get you a bunch of accessories on this, pulling them off was actually kind of stiff in some places, and I think that they had it right the first time. It's clearly some sort of cost-saving element, less molds, less components, lower BOM. It's the same overarching principle where they're not painting this side, whereas I think that this is a clever way to cost save and get some actual deco on both sides of the blaster. This is actually detrimental to the end user experience, which is just a little sad from the number one blaster brand. Let's put a few over the chronograph, see what our 90-foot range claims, 85-foot range claims are gonna get us. This is pretty important. So 63, 71, 68, 52, 70, 68, nothing. So it seems like, with the slight exception of a couple of outliers possibly, this guy is getting elite standard performance, which is to say that I anticipate there will be nothing new or exciting in terms of the spring constant inside. Let's go ahead and put a couple over, and by a couple I mean four over in slam fire mode, see what those numbers look like. 70, 68, 71, and duplicate 71. Actually hits higher FPS in slam fire, and part of that's just probably how the volume's being delivered right off the break like that. It's very clean, it's very consistent. Overall, I think that the performance of this isn't bad. It's just going to come in as a little bit pricey compared to pistols of yore. And I think that since there have been no actual innovations in revolver Springer style retracting slide top blasters, that you're far, far better served picking up. Honestly, you should pick up a Hammer Shot. The Hammer Shot's the best pistol Hasbro has produced in the last 10 years, and you can get them at like bargain prices pretty much no matter where you look. However, go on Amazon.com. This guy hasn't officially been released yet. It should be around at the end of the summer. So if you're interested in this, check out the link. It's an Amazon referral link to a pistol that'll do everything that this does, but better, in a more compact, cleaner, better decoed shell. I'll throw a link down in the description box to what I think is a far superior alternative down there. Overall, let me know, guys, what do you think? That's our first look at the Elite 2.0's actual performance, and again, sincerely, it does help with the algorithm. If you want to see me crack this guy open, if you want to see me put the spring up, if you want to see me like modify this and make an honest blaster of it yet, leave me a thumbs up on this video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell, and that way you won't miss it when we spoil a few more blasters like this. A lot of these blasters are starting to get leaked, and I know that we have a pretty good track record of getting you guys first reviews, so if that's the kind of thing that you appreciate, if you like seeing the new blaster reviews first, subscribe, bell, comment, come on guys, do all the cool stuff. And if you want to support the channel in other ways, there are links all in the description box down below. As always guys, much love, Nerf on, Drac out.